No matter who you are or where you are in life's journey, you are welcome here at Christ Church UCC on this dark winter evening for this blue Christmas service. We can ask, why are we here? Christmas can be a painful time for some. It may be the first Christmas without a loved one who has recently passed. It may be a time that has always been difficult. The constant refrain on radio and television, in stores and churches, about the happiness of the season, about getting together with family and friends, reminds many people of what they have lost or have never had. The anguish of broken relationships, the insecurity of unemployment, the weariness of ill health, the pain of isolation. All these can make us feel very alone in the midst of celebrating and spending. We need the space and time to acknowledge our sadness and concern. We need to know that we are not alone. Our spirits sink as days grow shorter. We feel the darkness growing deeper around us. We need encouragement to live the days ahead of us. This blue Christmas service is a way to acknowledge the pain that the Advent and Christmas seasons sometimes ignore and sometimes cause. The emphasis on family, joy, giving, and good cheer can be difficult for those of us who have experienced loss of one another through death, relocation, or broken relationships. It can be unpleasant for those who live with depression or other illnesses, those who have no jobs or little money for giving, and those who have addictions make the emphasis on parties very stressful. Today, on this evening in Advent, we gather to acknowledge our pain and to be open to a glimpse of the light of Christ. And so, we light the Christ candle. This flicker of light will burn throughout the service, symbolizing for us the light of Christ that shines and can be extinguished by no darkness. May the words, the music, and the silence, and the flames of candles open a channel in your heart to the warm, engulfing love of God. Join me in our call to worship. As we gather to worship in the darkness here, the reassuring words of the prophet Isaiah.
In the time of our sorrow, God has healed us.
The people who walked in darkness have seen the great light. On those who lived in a land of deep shadow, a light has shone. For the yoke that was weighing upon them and the burden upon their shoulders, God, our Redeemer, has broken in pieces.
Let us turn our hearts and minds to worship our God.
Pray with me. God of mercy, Hear our prayer this Advent season for ourselves and for our families who live with the painful memories of loss.
We ask for strength for today, courage for tomorrow, and in peace for the past. We look for light behind darkness, for brightness for the walk in the gloom.
Come, gracious God, come in quiet hope. Come in gentle assurance and tender mercy. Come with healing to make us whole.
We ask these things in the name of your Christ, who shares our life in the joy of our sorrow, death and endure, despair and our house. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 40. It was written at a time when many of the people of Judah had been taken as captives into exile in Babylon, and were feeling crushed and without hope. Before I read Isaiah's word, locate a place within yourself that feels crushed and without hope. May these words bring comfort, hope, and strength to you, as they did to captives in Babylon. Comfort, oh comfort my people, says your God. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway of our God. Every valley shall be lifted, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what should I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades. When the breath of the Lord blows upon it, surely the people are grass. But grass withers, the flower fades. But the word of our God will stand forever. Lift up your voice with strength. O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings, lift it up. Do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Why you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. God does not faint or grow weary. God's understanding is unsearchable. God gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youth will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint.
Thank you.
Every morning, the world is created. Under the orange sticks of the sun, the heat ashes of the night turn into leaves again and fasten themselves to the high branches, and the ponds appear like black cloth on which are painted islands of summer lilies. If it is your nature to be happy, you will swim away along the soft trails for hours, your imagination alighting everywhere. And if your spirit carries within it the thorn that is heavier than lead, if it's all you can do to keep on thrudging, there is still somewhere deep within you a beast shouting to that the earth. Is exactly what is wanted. Each pond with its blazing lilies is a prayer heard and answered lavishly. Every morning, whether or not you have ever dared to be happy, whether or not you have ever dared to pray. This is one possibility. It's an interpretation of what Mary may say. I'll pretend I'm female. Life often overwhelms me. My boy is dead. Killed. Things were going along fairly smoothly until I was 14. I got pregnant, and I did not even know who the father was. Luckily, Joseph. Good, kind Joseph. He did not have me cast out or stoned, but took me as his wife. But then, the pregnancy was hard, as I had to travel for the census. My poor child, who was born on the straw being fed to a cow, filling the beast's manger, not even a bed for us. Life has been hard. Then King Herod went crazy. He had all the little boys killed. I was so afraid for my baby. Joseph wisely had us flee to Egypt. I didn't know the language or the customs of the people. I was always a foreigner there. Everything was so strange. And things seemed to return to normal when we returned to Nazareth. But life was always precarious under the Romans. Now my boy is dead, killed. The darkness seems to want to wrap itself around me. God, I know you are with me, but today, you feel so far away. The story of the first Christmas is not really a happy story, but a story about life in the real world. Unwed, pregnant, and only 14 years old. Not a happy start to the story, or a relationship. A country under occupation, a cruel ruler. No security, no peace, not a happy setting for a story, or a new family, the slaughter of innocent children. For the people in Bethlehem, the birth of Jesus would always remind them of the army that massacred their children. And Joseph's frail little family flees for their lives to a strange land. Not a happy story. Mary, mother of Jesus, may her faith through her darkness shine light into our lives.
Thank you.
reading from Lamentations chapter 3, verse 1 to 3, 19 to 26. I am one who has seen affliction under the rods of God's wrath. God has driven and brought me into darkness without any light. Against me alone God turns a hand, again and again all day long. The thought of my affliction and my homelessness is wormwood and gall. My soul continually thinks of it and is bowed down within me. But this is I call to mind, and therefore I hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. God's mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I will hope in God. The Lord is good to those who wait, to the soul that seeks God. It is good to that one shall wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. As we light four candles of Advent throughout the season, tonight we light four candles to help us remember both our pain and the hope of our faith. We light these candles to remind us that no darkness can banish the light of Christ from our lives. The first candle we light to remember those whom we have loved and lost. We pause to remember their name, their face, their voice, the memory that binds them to us in this season. I invite anyone who wishes to remember a person that you have lost to come forward and light a tea candle. And if you are comfortable doing so, say the name of your loved one out loud, that we may all share in this moment of light and remembrance.
somewhere.
And I'm her bloom.
The bottom. What's in here?
Rotten girl.
My husband, Roger. Got me down off a good friend.
My grandmother, Emily Goon, who always made Christmas special.
My dad, Julio. My best friend, Billy. For my mom. Let us pray. God, surround those we have loved and lost with your eternal love. Amen. The second candle we light to redeem the pain of loss, the loss of relationships, the loss of jobs, the loss of health. We pause to gather up the pain of the past and to offer it to God, asking that from God's hands we might receive the gift of peace. I invite anyone who wishes to come forward to light a tea candle, to mark a loss or disappointment in your life, and to ask God to shine light upon your situation. Let us pray. God, refresh, restore, and renew us, and lead us into your future. Reading from Matthew chapter 5, verses 3 to 12. Hear the words of Mary, mother of Jesus. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the reign of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. The third candle we like to remember ourselves this Christmas time. We pause and remember these past weeks and months. The disbelief, the anger, downtimes, the memory shared, the hugs and handshakes of family and friends, all those who have stood with us. We pause to remember and give thanks for all the support we have received. Now I invite you once more to come forward if you wish to light a tea candle. Give thanks for those who have supported and comforted you during dark times, if you are comfortable doing so. Let us pray. God, we remember your promise that the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness will never extinguish it. This fourth candle is lit to remember our faith and the gift of hope, which the Christmas story offers to us. Let us call it Mary's candle. Mary knew what it was like to be afraid. Mary knew also the wonder of God's presence. We remember that God, Emmanuel, is with us. Through the loss of those we love and the frightening and disappointing events of our lives, God is the light, and it's in God there is no darkness. And if you have any other intentions that are weighing heavy on you that were not mentioned, you have an opportunity now to come and light another candle. as we celebrate Christmas this year. Let us keep in mind that in the Holy Land, the land that Jesus was born in, is under extreme turmoil. The land that he ran for with his family when he was in the womb to avoid being killed, murdered, the first time around, has not seen thousands and thousands of innocent children being killed under rubble. We lift them up in prayer that God can instill hope in them and in us as we witness this is horrendous actions. We notice I turn out the rest of the candles and one that didn't light. I want you to imagine that one life representing of thousands and thousands of innocent people that have been killed in Gaza. Innocent Palestinians that continue to be murdered. The innocent Palestinian Christians who have canceled all Christmas services this year in solidarity with those who live in Gaza. We are here. We might have other things on our minds, but sometimes even world news weighs heavy on some people. I know it's weighed heavy on me. Like Mary, we have hope, believing that God can bring light into our darkness, that sorrow and the hurts of our lives will pass. They will not disappear, but they will be healed. And like Mary, we sing our song of praises. Let us pray, you are the light of the world. Be the light in our darkness, O Christ. We pray.
We pray for ourselves, our loved ones, and for the peace of the land, and for the angels, to come throughout the whole world.
God of great compassion and love, listen to the prayers of these young people and people of all ages to grant to all, especially the bereaved and the troubled ones this Christmas, your blessing. Grant to all, especially the bereaved and troubled ones this Christmas, the blessing we ask in the name of Christ who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The light has splintered the darkness. Hope is ours once more. The light calls us forward, remembering the past and walking confidently into the future. Let us close by singing Silent Night. You are invited to enjoy the space in silence after the service is over. And if you would like to talk or ask for prayers, I'll be available. Go from this holy time and space, filled with hope, peace, and love, God's gift to all. Amen.